Oh, from earlier when she had the.
Oh my god.
Well, we good? We're still recording.
Yeah, I know. That's right, the best so part. Yeah.
Should we go?
Yeah, ready to just hit start? Yeah. Let's just do it.
We gotta do the intro again.
Oh, yeah, right. Hi, I'm Pfizer.
I'm P. This is like our fourth intro.
Yeah.
So many technical difficulties.
It's going great.
No audio.
Oh yeah, no audio.
Which is a good catch, because we would have done that.
No, I would have. I'm telling you, I would not.
Some video issues.
Lighting. And then
I think it's still fucked up, but I think it'll be okay.
No, I'm like really pasty. Like, I swear I'm not this white. I think he's just trying to paint me in a bad
light. No, I think we'll fix it in post. We'll be
You'll like desaturate me. Yeah. Or no, you'll have to saturate me. And desaturate yourself.
Yeah, we'll have to do some coloring.
Cut this down the middle, and then make you lighter and me darker.
Yeah,
I like it.
No, we'll be okay.
Like, it's just tan me, make me full bronze, honestly, and then also give me washboard abs, if you can. I don't know if I'm asking enough yet, but
this episode's gonna go great.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I'm already having a hard time taking it seriously because it's just Harry Potter. Well, it's not Harry Potter, but it's Harry Potter.
Woman in black.
Yes, woman in black. With Harry Potter.
Yes, with Harry Potter.
He's never going to shake that.
Yeah.
Even though he's great in BoJack.
I mean, dude, he's great in a lot of things.
He is a very good actor. It's just that, yeah, once you're Harry Potter, it's going to take, like, the next generation to get older to grow up without the Harry Potter like we did, you know? And, the one below us.
I think so. Like, he's done a lot of good things, but not something as popular as Harry Potter. So, if there's, like, let's say...
Will he ever?
Hopefully.
Maybe. Right? I hope so. Really? Yeah, I hope so.
It's if he does like one movie, right? That's fucking Daniel Radcliffe.
Yeah.
And then that movie lives on. Mm-hmm. And then another generation will watch Harry Potter and be like, oh yeah, shit, that's Daniel Radcliffe.
Right.
This from the Harry Potter. Yeah. Not Harry Potter playing other shit.
You never know. I mean, some people's careers, you know, I mean, well, Alan Rickman, you know, was obviously Hans Gruber and also Snape.
Yeah.
So, you know, but I guess he never was really... I guess typecast as a villain, kind of.
Yeah.
Kind of. You know? I guess. But either way. Well, no. Galaxy Quest. He was great in Galaxy Quest. So, there's that. I know. Whatever. It's a feel good movie. Anyway, but, so this, either way, I don't know anything about other than it came out the same year as Deathly Hallows Part 2. The end of most of our childhoods, basically. You know?
Is it?
Well, I mean, not really.
Yeah.
You know, kind of, when you think about it. I think that, like, once you get past, like, 21, that's really when childhood kind of ends. You're a fucking kid till you're 20. You're still a kid when you're 25, in my mind now. And even being 32 and seeing how different I am at 32 from 25.
That's true.
It's completely 180 different. Yeah. I say 180 because it turns.
Yeah.
It doesn't go all the way around. That's then right. I'd be right back where I was. We don't want a 360. We want a 180.
That would be bad.
That would be bad if we went back to 25-year-old Pfizer. That would be a good time. But that being said, 2012, this one went under the radar for me. I've never heard of it. You saw it in a comment, right?
Yeah, I saw it in the comment by Taylor.
Taylor.
Shout out, Taylor.
Thank you.
There's some good comments. We saw the Possession from 1981.
We tried to look up Possession.
We couldn't find it anywhere.
If anybody out there could find it and can get us a link, we'll download it. We'll watch it. Yep. You know, where we would love to do the Possession. Apparently, that movie was banned in England. And there's some others we had on there. Doctor Sleep is on the list. We've got a long list. If anything, we have a hard time deciding what we want off the top of the list every time we come in here. But we are always adding to it. So please don't stop the comments from coming. We want to know what you guys want to hear.
Music.
Exactly. Yeah. Are you tangled up?
No. Just get back a little bit. Yeah.
Yeah. Good. Okay. Cool. So anyway. Yeah. I don't know anything about it. I don't know what it's about. I just know that Harry Potter's in it, and I didn't recognize... I did a quick look at the cast sheet. I don't recognize anybody on there.
Yeah.
So, I guess we'll see when we get into it, but...
Yep. Less technical difficulties.
Yes. Maybe. Let's see.
We'll see.
You're gonna hit start, and it's gonna blow up.
Full screen?
Yes. No, we should do half screen.
Do the honors.
Oh, I'll do it. All right. Oh, are we gonna see dead kids to start a movie again?
Yo, we...
I don't know what it is with us and starting movies. Those are like porcelain dolls. Jesus.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah. These kids are gonna die.
Oh no, dude.
So a new PBR tradition. We start a movie with dead children.
What is, bro? Ever since we came back,
I don't know what it
kids
is.
Kids have been dying.
Yeah.
In movies.
Harry Potter. All right, that's my one. I had to do one. The Mirror of RSA. All right, fine. All right, that's it. I swear I'm done.
Oh.
Oh, wait. She's not... I thought she was, like, out of frame and she's gonna walk in.
Oh, shit. We're already seeing ghosts. Oh,
flashback. Okay.
Did she die in, like, childbirth?
Oh, well, maybe. This is definitely older, so... Mm. I mean, shit, people still die in childbirth today.
Oh, interesting cut.
Yeah.
Right before the reveal.
Right.
So, presumably, we'll begin getting back into that.
Mm-hmm.
It's a boy.
Look really sad to deliver this boy to him.
Very sorry, Mr. Gibbs.
She has to have died. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that is fucking terrible.
Yeah, that's rough.
One of the worst and the best days of your life, all in the same.
Good night.
What's creepy, like the fucking headless porcelain doll in there? Ugh.
Oh, yeah, that's the parents.
Oh, it was their kids. So, okay, so no, he's not supposed to go here. Wherever he's supposed to go, it was like the lady had one kid who died. This is somewhere completely different.
The London train leaves in half an hour. My colleague Keckwick is waiting outside with your luggage.
They're trying to get him out of here as quickly as possible.
Yeah.
Something is going on.
I'm wondering if it's like a haunting of some kind. Oh, yeah, I ain't getting on that.
Mr. Keckwick, change of plans. I'm not catching the train. You'll take me to Ealmarsh House.
Okay. This is literally like the fucking Dead Marshes or something.
Mm-hmm.
Cool setting, though, for this. Yeah, not, it's kind of run down.
I say, I don't need to go in there.
Yeah. It's like, yeah, just tell them that the rats got to the papers, you know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah.
Call those college hunks hauling junk, guys.
Yeah.
Get them in there. Let them handle it.
Oh, these shots, man. I'm always expecting something, you know?
Yep, see, there you go.
Yeah.
Well, there's the woman in black.
I knew something was going to move. Mm-hmm. I didn't think it was going to be something that was already there.
Mm-hmm. Did that get you?
Yes, dude. It's pretty loud up here. I'm going to turn the volume down a little bit.
Oh. I kind of expected someone to come to that.
Yeah, meeting. Yeah, yeah. A lot of like lingering shots right now where I'm just expecting something to like move.
Oh, he's got Dookie on him.
Oof. Yut. The bird.
Oh, no. Oh, little baby bird.
Oh. Motherfucker. They got me.
God
again.
Damn ravens. Ugh.
Oh.
Did I see somebody standing up?
Oh, yup. A woman in black. There.
That Michael Myers
is.
Thing. Gone, right?
Yep. Time to go.
Hello?
I heard a horse.
Yeah.
I gotta swear that I heard like a horse. Yep. Yeah, I do. Okay, yeah.
Definitely. Definitely a horse. Yeah, get on a horse. Okay, that's not a horse.
That's a goat.
They do scream.
I'm surprised that people weren't like, don't go there, it's haunted.
Yeah.
And so they're just like, we're just going to try to keep you out of there.
Oh, this is kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
Kekwick!
Oh, the kid fucking...
Oh, ooh. No. Did they, like, get stuck in a mud or something?
Ooh.
Mother...
That happened.
She drank some lye. Our mom was out.
Lye? Oh, God. It's gonna be alright, darling. Just let me get a look at you.
Dude, how many kids are gonna get murdered in this fucking... Or I guess they're not getting murdered. How many kids are gonna just die in this movie?
Weird.
We're up to 4 child deaths now?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Well, three. Three girls.
The three at the beginning and then her.
Well, and then I guess the boy in the marshes.
Mm-hmm, he counts, so we have 5. Yeah. We have 5 dead kids so far.
Jeez.
Hello? This is Fisher.
I am trying so hard to not make Harry Potter jokes. I'm trying so hard.
I can't leave yet.
Please don't go back to Eel Marsh House.
Why?
I'm wondering if, like, if somebody goes there, does it take a kid?
Yeah.
Maybe. Like a vengeful soul or something like that, or a vengeful spirit.
Nicholas loved to sketch too. He still does.
Oh.
Hmm.
He wants to draw you a picture.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth. No.
That is so creepy.
Oh, that's the medication?
He chloroformed her ass.
The medication.
I mean, you know what? I guess then, like, they'll probably just go put some leeches on her upstairs, too.
Yeah.
She has ghosts in her blood. Get it out. Dutch angle. It's fine. Just do it every once in a while, whatever.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, don't do it again.
Uh-oh.
Eyes gonna pop up looking at him.
Oh.
See?
Oh, the late tide is due at 11. I'll come back for you then.
It's fine. I'd rather just work through the night.
Take the dog. Come on, go. Just for company.
Yes, absolutely. I will take the dog.
Nothing better happen than a dog, bro. What a good dog, though.
Right.
Right?
Yeah, I mean, kill the kids, but the dog, no.
Yeah. Well trained. It's like, go with them.
And the dog's like, you got it, buddy.
Yeah. I'll keep him. I'll keep him safe.
Yep.
Oh, he definitely saw that. Oh, one of those things. I feel like it's always creepy.
Yeah, I would just like... Oh, that was creepy.
Hello? Bro, time to dip, like but I said. Like,
also, why can't you just, like, grab all the papers and just, like, just take them?
Yeah, right?
Like, just, like, why do you have to do it there? Just take them with you. He's like, come on, I gotta show you something.
Yeah.
It's a good dog, I'll tell you what. I want a pit bull with me for this situation. Or like a German Shepherd. That's a person. That was not a tree. That was a person.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Fuck, I missed it.
He didn't miss much. It was a person.
That is creepy.
I would just go stand by the shoreline.
Yeah. Take the dog. Chill outside.
Chill outside.
Until the dude comes back for his dog.
Yeah. Fuck this. Now I'm out here.
Yeah.
Ooh. That's creepy.
Very.
Sister, at your refusal to let me visit my son or even give him my birth
cards. They like stole the kid.
From her sister?
But to cause me pain, he is mine. If you won't let me see him, I will find a way.
I mean, the handwriting's definitely gotten worse. Ooh, in the picture.
Right. But you know what? Maybe like she was actually like sick. And they had to do it, I don't know.
Right.
You didn't try to save him. You just saved yourself. You didn't even give him a proper burial. You just left him there in the mud.
Ooh.
His blood is on your hands.
Body not recovered? Oh, so it's like it's a not put to rest kind of thing.
Yeah.
Great time to take a nap.
Yeah. Wake up. Oh no, dude, wake up. Oh,
I'm gonna say, yeah. Can I see her in the mirror? I wasn't sure.
Yeah, doggy.
Yeah, wake his ass up, dog.
Bark, bark. Uh oh.
Maybe she has Freddy Krueger rules, you know?
Ooh.
Like, you gotta be asleep.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, but he's been seeing her while he's,
Well, seeing her, but she's not really fucking with him yet, though. True. I mean, well, she's fucking with him, but not, like... Okay, so is that the sound of his heavy-ass clodhoppers walking up the stairs? But no.
Something's going on in that room that he couldn't get into. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, fuck it. Just break it down, bro. Yeah, yes.
Oh, I thought he was going to, like, start running.
Oh, no, okay. I think he's getting something. He's going to hear his Johnny this shit. Oh! That's unsettling.
Uh-oh.
I don't think hatchets work against, like, ghosts. Just call it a hunch.
It's fucking empty. Oh!
No, it ain't.
Oh, shit.
No, it ain't. It looks like Helena Bonham Carter, too.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, I'm trying really hard not to make Harry Potter jokes. This movie's making it very, very difficult, man.
Creepy fucking teeth, yeah. On that doll, man.
Dude, old toys used to be so fucking creepy.
Yeah.
You could have saved. Oh,
man. Motherfucker. Every time. All these jump scares get me, dude. Oh, is that where it happened? Like, literally, right where the cross
was? It has to be, yeah. That...
Oh,
is it the kid?
Oh, is he coming out of there?
It's like the ring girl coming out of the TV.
Oh, he's just standing there. Oh, okay. Time to dip. I keep saying, this is it, dude. It's gotta run by that kid. Oh, from earlier when she had the...
Oh my god.
Oh, the fucking things. Just open the door, bro. What are you gonna do? What else are you gonna do?
You have to look down, it's a child.
Yeah. Oh!
Oh, that's a lot of dead kids.
Yeah. Oh, no. Don't follow it. What are you doing? Run by the dead children and just get out of here, man.
You're really gonna do? I would fuck up 10-year-olds. I have, like, zero fear. Like, 10-year-olds, like, those, especially those kids, half of them were, like, little girls. Not to be sexist. I'm just saying, I would fuck them. I would grab one of the kids and start hitting them with the other kids, you know?
Swinging them.
Yeah. By the ankles, just yeeting them around. I have no fear. Dude, I just... Just smash all these dolls, bro.
Ugh, are we about to see a creepy kid?
Again. Probably there has to be. Yeah, there's no. Oh, yeah, well, there you go.
Oh, he's fast. He's so. Oh no.
Oh. Oh, that's why it was swinging.
Just leave the candle. Oh, it's already out. Just leave the candle. Time to dip, bro.
Oh yeah, like.
Of course.
Something it's gonna be behind you. Right there.
I was expecting that one.
Yeah.
But yeah, Muddy Kid.
That's, like the Mud Men from Left 4 Dead 2. Also, he hasn't gone back there. Oh, that's why.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a gross sound. I better say, it's like the sound of like toes and like mud is what that sounds like. Yeah, just. Like stepping on worms, you know?
Okay. Yeah. Oh, slipping on the mud. Time to go.
Well, now you gotta go face all the children. Oh.
Yeah, get me out of here, please. Okay, it's over. Oh.
Yep, all right, movie all over. Right.
Good, he survived. Oh, their kid is locked in the basement. Oh, damn, it looks like it's cooking in there.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, she did it.
Yeah, it seems like the thing makes the girls just kind of like kill themselves. Don't do it.
No!
I mean, it was already happening, right, before he came, so, like...
Well, that's what I'm wondering. Like, did it... Like, was it not happening while nobody was going up to the house, maybe?
Yeah, maybe.
And then as soon as people started going... Like, he started going back up there, that's when it happened again?
Could be.
Mrs. Daly?
The kid? Is he taking possession?
She makes us do it. She
makes us. They took her boy away, so now she takes us.
That's so creepy.
Yeah. Oh no, they just like drowned.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she's there.
Right, yeah, she's okay.
Yep, she's there too.
She saw you. She saw you. She's coming.
Joseph.
The train!
His
kid's drawing.
We can reunite Janet Humphrey with her son. Perhaps she'll finally be at peace.
I knew it. Going under, I think.
We just gotta do by feel, I guess, right?
Well, yeah, you ain't gonna see.
Sam, I feel it! It's just beneath my feet! Give me a moment while I tie it!
Be careful!
I would say just give me 30 seconds. I'm gonna go down and grab it, and then you just drag my ass out.
Yeah.
Oh. Doesn't look like a skeleton.
It's the whole carriage, I think.
Jeez.
That's not what I was expecting, but yeah, makes sense.
Well, get out, you're making it heavier.
Oh no. Yeah, get the boy.
The engine's overheating!
Oh no, shit's going back. You gotta jump out or something.
Right.
Okay, now what though?
Just put the boy in the bed, I guess, and
just put him in the ground, Arthur. Let's get it over with.
Yeah, bury him. There you go.
There you go.
There's something I need to do first.
They're lost. They need to find each other.
What do you have to do?
Well, you have to put it to rest somehow, so I'm assuming he's going to find a way to reunite the mom and the kid.
Mm.
I just don't know how yet. I appreciate his lack of fear, but, like, I don't even believe in ghosts or anything like that. I just would not do this.
Yeah.
I had a customer once that had, like, a collection of American Girl dolls. Like, those 3 foot tall, dolls. I walked, opened the door, saw a wall full. I freaked the fuck out. It was so creepy. It's where their main water shop is, so I had to go in there. But I was like, it's... That's my least favorite one.
It's like, that's the most realistic looking one.
Yeah. That's fucking creepy. Yeah, maybe they're not doing this right. Maybe they're getting this wrong.
There's something that's not right.
Yeah.
Maybe that's not her kid.
Oh, jeez. I was like, there's furries in here now, but it was just in the toy.
I don't like these POV shots, bro.
There she is.
Is she gonna come, like, real quickly down the hallway? Like...
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yep. Yep. Bruh. She already behind you. Oh.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I guess. What the fuck just happened? Is that it? Oh.
And what was the point of locking him away?
I guess she needed some privacy?
Maybe his kid did it as a favor, like hid him away so he didn't see her, so he couldn't cause the kid to die or keep the curse going. It's possible. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, maybe his kid saved him.
I think she's gone.
You think? Is it that easy?
Maybe. That seems to imply that it's not over.
Right.
It's like, hey, thanks for my kid back, but,
No!
I think we got a dead kid coming.
No! Not little Joseph. Oh, no.
Mm-hmm.
Is this about to happen right now? Oh no. Oh no.
It's both of them.
They made it, right?
I don't think so, bro. No, look, they're all there.
Yeah,
they got hit, man.
Oh no, and this is where they just all exist
now. So they're just in the upside down now?
Oh no.
Daddy, who's that lady?
That's your mommy.
Oh. Mm. It's kind of like the end of Drag Me to Hell.
Yeah. Creepy. Don't you fucking look at me, lady.
Yeah, right.
Well.
Yeah, that was an interesting one. It's not horribly unique in its style, or like, you know, the whole like soul not at rest kind of story,
right?
I guess
haunting.
But this might be the most child deaths that we've seen in a movie,
definitely.
And there were a lot of like legitimate scares. I would say that like jump scares for me, they're not as strong because these are my thing. I've been watching a lot of these kind of movies, so like it just doesn't really do it for me. But there were a few moments here that were genuinely creepy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a big fan of stuff in the background, creepy shots. I feel like those are always like, they don't feel cheap because you have to see them. You have to recognize it, you know? Whereas jump scares are always based on something popping out with a sound usually brought to it. So while I usually deduct points for just overuse of jump scares, I will say this movie does have a lot of genuinely creepy moments. It does make you wonder what's going on the whole time. Like, is this a soul at rest kind of thing? Is it just like a ghost that's just pissed or something like that?
Right.
So it was fun to try to sit here and guess where this was go. And I gotta say, this is like the perfect running time for a movie like this. It was an hour and a half. It didn't drag out a huge, long, crazy, convoluted story.
Yep.
It was a pretty straightforward, this woman lost her child and she is seeking revenge on the town. The town doesn't like deserve it. They didn't do anything wrong, you know?
Yeah.
But you know, there's also a little bit more depth to the story. Obviously she was mentally ill of some kind and her family, you know, so there's stuff to rewatch it for and get. And only one Dutch angle that I caught. I caught one Dutch angle. So pleasantly surprised. What do you think?
Yeah, I agree with you. The jump scares, they get me every time, which is fine.
I'm never gonna fault anybody for jumping in a jump scare. That's what it's designed for.
But I agree with you on like the behind the kind of over the shoulder reveal things, because they're not like cheap. They're just, they're actually like there to progress the story, right? It's it gets more frequent. You get to see more in the background. So it's like, you know,
that's a hard shot to make too. Yeah. So that you have to quickly adjust focus on them in some cases. There's it's not as simple as just kind of like, okay, frame now.
Yeah.
You know, we're quick at it.
It might be that we may have even missed a whole bunch. You know, just like I'm a huge fan of Haunting of Hill House.
Yes.
And I've seen that like 3, 4, 5 times over. There's a lot going on. And, you know, a lot of the times there's just like things there. You see it on the third watch. Mm-hmm. You're like, oh shit, like that's it. And it makes sense later on. But yeah, I agree with you. It's like a pretty simple story, haunting, you know. I was rooting for little Joseph to survive there.
I know,
he didn't. But interesting ending with the mother and everything. So I think that's, you know, not bad.
Yeah.
Not bad. I think it could have been worse, you know. But I do think I'm missing something at the end. Why, like that whole thing, they went through the process of like getting the child back. It didn't work. I guess because she's just a vengeful soul now.
Yeah, it's an all for naught kind of thing. And I guess that, like, you know, maybe there's just no way to put her to rest, which, like, so I kind of wish that was a little bit more clearly defined. I don't mind when movies have open interpretation endings, but, like, so for example, Drag Me to Hell, which also ends with somebody dying on train tracks at the end, that was very clear why that happened, because in the context of the story, she was supposed to return an item to a dead body, but she grabbed the wrong envelope and you didn't know it till the end. And so because she didn't actually complete the ritual, that's why she died. So there's a reason why she died at the end of that movie. She didn't really complete the ritual. And here, I guess it doesn't go in depth of the lore of what they might need to do in order to stop this from happening. And I guess that I did briefly, when I was just kind of looking at the cast, I was just quickly scrolling through Wikipedia. I guess there was a potential sequel, or there might have been a sequel. So maybe they do go into it more, but it's probably a direct-to-video or something. But either way, that being said, it's open-ended in a way that I kind of don't like, because it doesn't answer any questions, and it doesn't leave us with pondering questions other than like, well, what could they have done?
What happened?
Why should they have just run?
Didn't work? Yeah.
You know?
Because it was put to, like, the whole sequence of them, you know, like getting reunited was presented to us as if it was working or was going to work. Obviously, it didn't. We knew that, right, before the train scene.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not clear why.
Oh, another example. In The Ring, or Ringu, which basically more or less does have the same ending.
Yeah.
You know, the reason why she got away in most is because she made a copy. But the guy in both versions didn't get away because he didn't make a copy.
Yeah.
So there's a clear rule. Because that was the thing at the end of... They were more clear in the English version of The Ring because, like, the kid was like, help her. Mm-hmm. You weren't supposed to help her. They kind of added that. You know, like, Yoichi was in, like, the Ringu series and everything, but he didn't really have a big role in the first movie. The kid in the American version, Naomi Watts version, I want to say, had a much bigger role and directly told her, like, you weren't supposed... Like, he was, like, a surrogate for the audience to kind of let us understand what was going on. So, didn't happen here.
Yeah, outside of that, enjoyable. Yeah, thanks for the recommendation.
Yeah. Would you give it out of...
I would give it a 6.
6?
Yeah.
I was going to say, I give it 6 Harry Potter ones.
Yeah, 6 Harry Potter 10. Ones.
I was, like... A 5 is too mean.
Yeah.
Because
no, like, it had good shots.
Yeah,
The setting was awesome.
The acting was great.
Yeah, the acting was great.
Editing was good. The sound was good.
Yeah, the creepiness of the dolls and everything.
Yes.
Yeah, like, that was great.
Yeah. It's,
I think it's just a storytelling.
Right, it was not an original story whatsoever. And then on top of that, a lot of cheap jump scares.
But hey, you know, when you go into movies like this, well, 6 is essentially what I expect anyway.
Yeah.
So, there you go.
I always tell people a 6 is good. People need to stop thinking that 6 is bad. Because, like, there are, my favorite movie of all time is a 6. Yeah. You know? Like, there are a lot of Kung Fu movies are 6s when you think about it, you know? Because, like, dude, a lot of Jackie Chan movies, as much as I fucking love Jackie Chan, I kind of have to skip a lot. I have to skip a lot because there's a lot of stupid stories not good in those movies, you know? So there's...
And 10s are very rare. So it's essentially you're looking at from, like, 5 to 9. This is, like, kind of what you're looking at.
We haven't given 10. I think we gave, what, Dune got a 9. 9 for me. Did you give Dune a 10?
I don't think so.
Yeah?
I don't remember.
I don't know what we... I know I gave last week a 9. I gave the Devil and the Blacksmith. I gave that a 9.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think if there's another movie that I gave a... I know I gave Primal Fear and... I might have given a 10. I don't know. I might have given a 10 to Primal Fear.
But yeah, that's, you know, 10's like a... 10's up there, man. It's very rare. But,
yeah, it's hard to get that. But yeah. a 6 is a recommendation for me. Even 5's recommendations usually, but 6 is a recommendation for me. If you haven't seen this
hour
yet,
and
guys,
a half,
check
like,
it out.
Yeah, hour and a half.
Yeah, put this on while you're, you know, like, I don't know, Friday night you have nothing to do, Saturday night you have nothing to do. Mm-hmm. Have a couple beers and watch this movie.
Yeah, get jump scared. But yeah, recommend more like this.
Yes.
Different Please. Than this. Yes. You know, things that have flown under the radar that we haven't seen.
Absolutely.
Put it in the comments. We'll definitely check it out.
Mm-hmm.
So,
appreciate you guys. Thanks.
Peace.